Hello everyone. Today I am going to teach you how to divide one polynomial by another polynomial. First of all, you have to take care of the degree of the polynomial. Degree is the power of the term. In this whole polynomial, if you will see that this term has got the maximum value as a power. So the degree of this polynomial will be 4. So first of all, we have to arrange these terms in such a way that the bigger degree should come before any other degrees. So if you will see that it is written in descending order, 4 power, 3 power, 2 power, 1 power and 0 power. Similarly, in divisor also we have to write them in such a manner. Okay, so when you have written like this, bigger degree polynomial here and smaller degree polynomial over here, and you can even look the size of the polynomial, this bigger polynomial and smaller polynomial. Now what we will do is we will have to take the first term of this polynomial, which is a dividend, and first term of smaller polynomial, that is 3x square. So what you have to do is you will see that first term of bigger polynomial was 3x power 4 and this one, and first term of this polynomial is 3x square. So what we will do is we will write just one above the other and we will divide it. 3, say 3 cancel, then this will cancel it out and this. Okay, now you need to check how I have done this thing. What you have to do is, if you are not able to understand this, you can write like this. 3x upon 3 and 4 minus 2 power. So 4 power was of this term and 2 power was of this term. So I have just subtracted their powers. 3 and 3 cancel. So x power 2. So this x power 2 we will write as a quotient over here. X power 2. Now this x power 2 will be multiplied by this. So when we will multiply this x square with the divisor, divisor was 3x square minus 5, you can see 3x square minus 5, and this was the quotient. We will have to multiply these two. For multiplying this, we will multiply x square with 3x square, so that will become 3x power 4. Why power 4? Because we will have to add these powers. Minus, then 5 with x square becomes 5x square. Now we will copy that value here. 3x power 4 minus 5x. See, this was 5x square, not 5x cube. So we won't write here. We will have to write it below the square power. That means here, minus 5x square. For this, you have to be super conscious, because if you will not write the like terms below each other, you can make mistake. So you need not to write 5x square below x cube. You have to write below the like terms. Now we will change their sign. There is no sign, that means it was of positive sign. So we will change its sign from positive to negative, and this was negative, so we will write positive. See, their values are same, just a sign difference is there, so we can cancel it out. That will give us 0. Copy this value as it is with its sign, minus 15x cube. And now, as these both are positive signs, so we will add them and put the sign of positive. Plus 18x square. Plus 25x minus 30. See, if you will see what I have done, I have copied all the above line, just I have solved those values which are there. Again, same process that whatever we were doing, we were taking first term of the polynomial and dividing that polynomial, that term by its first term. So again, we will write like this, that was minus 15x cube divided by 3x square. Again, same process. By 3 we will cancel 15 5 times and we will subtract their degrees. So it will have only 1 degree. 3 minus 2 is 1. So we will get minus 5x. Now we will write minus 5x as quotient. Minus 5x. Now we will multiply minus 5x with these two terms. When we will multiply minus 5 with 3, we will get minus 15. And when we will multiply this x with this x square, we will get what? X cube. Now, if you will multiply minus 5x with minus 5. So when minus minus multiplies, it gives us plus sign. So again, see, if you will see, there is only x power 1. So we cannot write over here. We have to write over here. So that will be plus 25x. Again, same process. We will change their sign. Minus becomes plus and plus becomes minus. So if you will see, their numerical values are same, powers are same, only signs are different. That means we can cut them. Similarly here, this is plus, this is minus, we will cut them. So we will get 0 instead of that. Now we will copy those values which are above there. It is plus 18x square and minus 30. Same process again, 18x square divided by 3x square. 18x square divided by 3x square. X square cancel because they were similar. 3, 6 times. So we will write here in the quotient area, plus 6. This 6 will multiply with these two. When I will multiply this 6 with this, I will get 6 threes are 18. And power x square. Again, I will multiply 6 with 5. What I will get? Minus 30. 6 fives are 30. Now again, we will draw one line. There is no sign, that means it was positive. We will change this sign as negative. Negative will become positive. Opposite sign, cancel. Opposite sign, cancel. We got 0 remainder.